after overwintering at Leeds, it's now finally time to break out onto the open water and explore some new places. We're ditching Waterways Guide 5 and moving on to number 6, which I managed to get through the post. So yeah, I've done my homework and I think I know where I'm going. And yeah, we're just going to see what happens. So please join me, won't you, as we take on the Aire and Calder. So come on guys, let's crank it. Is that what I have to do? Do I have to say crank it on every video now? John and Michelle, they're moored up there, and might hopefully catch up with them at another time. Had a good time with them. We had some barbecues and stuff, which I didn't have a lot of chance to do last year for whatever reason. So it was just great to do that and do a few DIY jobs, a bit of painting. I also changed the fuel filter over, so got a bit more confidence now with the engine. Hopefully I've done everything now so that it won't conk out on a river, which is what I don't want to happen. But yeah, never focus on what you don't want to happen, focus on what you do want to happen. And or something. But now it's time to crank it, guys. Actually, there's plenty of time for cranking it. Let's just relax and enjoy how calm and still it is out here. You know, there's hardly any current, no wind. Just chill, man, come on. Big one, let's check it out. Take a moment to just see how big this lock is. You could fit probably about 20 narrowboats in here at my size. Absolutely incredible. It's 13 foot 6 inches deep, so definitely one of the deepest ones I've been in so far. Let's see how it goes. So I've just started the sluices going and I'm on the boat now, so I'm just, it's very gentle, the water's just letting out very, very slowly. But yeah, I'm going to have to stay on the boat now and just climb out when I can later on. If you're doing this single-handed, you can also tie onto these chains covered in plastic. It's not too bad. Just watch out for the bottom bits, it can catch. Right, so I've just turned the engine off, just so you can appreciate how massive this lock is. And the job I've got now to climb up. So I've got to go all up this nice greasy, slidey old ladder. So now the gates are open, I can go out, but I have to moor around the side there on the river, which could be a bit tricky. Let's see. To be honest with you, that was a lot easier than I was thinking it was going to be. Not so sure what it's like when you go up it though. That might be a different story. So if you're single-handed and you're thinking, oh, I might not be able to do that, I'm here to tell you that you can. I've just come up to Castleford now, so I've got to make sure I take the first left and not go over a massive weir. Here we are at the turning for, well, you can either go left or right, but you do not want to go straight on because that is where the weir is. Very happy to announce we've got some brand new crew members. We've got three Naughty Lass crew members and one full inductee of the Crank It crew on Patreon. So here we go. Ed Mendelssohn. Now Ed has been watching my videos and he said he's getting his own boat now. So good luck Ed with your boat and I hope this has all been of some help. Then we've got Lettuce Fire, which I think is just a hilarious name. I don't know what your real name is, but I hope you'll enjoy this shout out anyway. Thanks for supporting the vlog. And then we've got Jennifer Lemon. I hope that's how you pronounce your name. Jennifer, thank you so much. So all these people have sent one-off payments as appreciation for these vlogs, and yeah. So if you want to do that, then click on the link in the description below. And now we've got Dale Jones as the latest recruit to the Crank It crew. Dale, welcome aboard, sir. And if you want to join Dale, then you just have to support the vlog on Patreon, and I'll give you a shout out, and you'll get to see some secret extra things as well. Anyway, that's all from me on this vlog. Join me next time as we take on a little bit more of the River Aire, and then we're onto the Selby Canal and heading on towards the River Ouse, which eventually leads us to York. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching. Bye.